One thing our poll showed is that players are more concerned with other parts of their bodies being injured as opposed to head injuries. Why do you think?
I think primarily because with a head injury, with a concussion, it might be a one-week injury. By and large, it's not going to be longer than that, whereas if you get your knee taken out, you're looking at an eight-month recovery, you're done for the season, and that can impact your earning power in the long run, too.
And when you talk about head injuries and what we're learning about them, sometimes the long-term effects are not known until long after you've finished playing.
One positive in terms of the way that the culture is changing, there are more head injuries being reported. More guys are coming to the combine saying you have a history of concussions. They're more aware of it, but if you break down the numbers as we did, you don't see the same impact as if somebody has had a bunch of knee surgeries.
There are still players who don't want to come off the field, don't want to admit that they have concussions, and in some cases might have to be dragged off the field.
We've seen that a couple of times in the playoffs, too. Players refusing to leave the sidelines, sometimes making scenes. It can be tough for the doctors to be able just to get the helmet out of his hands.
One thing that I think is positive is that with all of this discussion, with the protocol, with the awareness that's there, it's not only the players themselves, it's the people around them. Wives, family members, agents, teammates. People are now more prone to step up and say, hey, maybe this is something that we need to get checked out a little deeper. Do you think the game is really safer now?
The players that we talked to, by and large, said either yes, it's safer, or it's about the same. Very few said it's less safe, but I think you still have a divide here between offensive players and defensive players because there is that perception among defensive players that the rules are all made to protect the skill guys on offense.
And that's a theme we've heard in this league for many years, and some of the players I talked to told me they still urge the competition committee to do even more in terms of protecting players in the trenches and maybe even eliminating cut blocking altogether.
Nearly a third of the players we surveyed, Jared, said the quality of the game is worse based on the new rules changes. In your opinion, how has the quality been impacted?
Well, I tell you, if you say a safer game is a better game, then I get that, okay? But I'm an old school guy, so sometimes I want to see some blood and guts. But, hey, the league has definitely made its point about safety, and you see it happening every week.
You don't see the blood and guts where you used to either. Every time a safety pulls off a receiver going over the middle, you can tell that's what's going through his head.